Good morning everyone. Today in this video we are going to see horizontal curves and super elevation. This is me, Dilruba KM. So horizontal curve is a curve in plan to provide change in direction to the center line of the road. When vehicle travels through a horizontal curve, the centrifugal force will act horizontally outward through the center of gravity of the vehicle. In this figure you can see when a vehicle negotiates a horizontal curve, when it's moving through a horizontal curve, there is a force acting outward through the center of gravity of this vehicle, and this force is known as centrifugal force. So this centrifugal force has some effect on this moving vehicle. Let us see what are the effects. So centrifugal force depends on two factors. They are radius of the horizontal curve. So if we consider this as an horizontal curve, then there might be some radius for this horizontal curve, and this radius will affect the centrifugal force and speed of the vehicle. So let us see how it will affect. If the radius is higher, then centrifugal force will be lesser. If the radius is smaller, that means if the curve is so sharp, then the centrifugal force will be so high. That you might have noticed this, when we take a smaller curve, I mean a curve with smaller radius or a sharp turn, more amount of forces trying to pull out us from that curve. So that is known as centrifugal force. So when the radius get into higher points, or when the radius is increasing, then centrifugal force definitely will reduce. Now coming to the speed, what about speed? When the speed is increasing, the centrifugal force will also increase. So speed of the vehicle is directly proportional to the centrifugal force, and radius of the curvature is inversely proportional to the centrifugal force. So centrifugal force is counteracted by transverse frictional force, which is developed between vehicular tire and the pavement. So when a centrifugal force is trying to pull it outward, there will be some frictional force developed between this tire and the pavement surface, and this frictional force will try to counteract this centrifugal force or prevent the vehicle to going outward. And this is why, and this is the reason why we could able to change the direction and maintain the stability. So the friction force is helping us to change the direction as well as maintain the stability of the vehicle in the circular curve. So I told you centrifugal force depends upon two factors, that is one is velocity of the vehicle and another one is radius of the curvature. And centrifugal force equation for centrifugal force is weight of the vehicle into v square, velocity squared by g into radius of horizontal curve. So w v square by gr, this is the equation for centrifugal force. In this equation you must know that the unit of centrifugal force is kilogram. And centrifugal ratio, while we evaluating or analyzing the effect of the centrifugal force, we will consider a centrifugal ratio. It is nothing but the ratio of centrifugal force to weight of the vehicle, that is P by W. So we can write centrifugal ratio is P by W is equal to V square by GR. Now effect of centrifugal force. When a vehicle moves through a horizontal curve, due to centrifugal force, there is a chance of this vehicle to overturn towards the outer direction of the curve. Or since the centrifugal force is acting outward, there is a chance of the vehicle to overturn towards the outer direction with respect to the outer wheel. And there is also a chance of the vehicle to skid laterally outward. So these are the two effects of centrifugal force. First one is overturning, second one is skidding. Now let us analyze the stability of the vehicle during overturning or transverse skidding while it is moving through a horizontal curve which is not provided with super elevation. You know what is super elevation? We will come to that point later. So let us see, we have a curve without any super elevation, or the outer edge of the road is not raised. So how this overturning and skidding will happen? Let us consider a vehicle moving through a curve. Centrifugal force will try to overturn the vehicle, and this overturning moment will be P into H, where P is the centrifugal force and H is the height of the center of gravity of the vehicle. So let us consider this figure. We have centrifugal force and H as the height of the center of gravity of the vehicle. So overturning moment will be P into H, which will be acting in this direction, okay, clockwise, and this will be counteracted by the weight of the vehicle, and which is acting downward through the center of gravity, and the over restoring moment due to the weight of the vehicle will be W into B by 2, where B is the width of the wheelbase or distance between two wheels. So width of the wheelbase by 2 into W is the moment developed due to weight of the vehicle, which is trying to counteract the overturning moment. So at equilibrium, we can write P into H is equal to W into B by 2, or we can write centrifugal ratio P by W is B by 2H. So we can write with P by W is equal to B by 2H, there is a danger of overturning. It is at the brim of overturning. When the P by W increases slightly, the vehicle will overturn. Transverse skidding effect. So in the similar manner, if we have considering the transverse skidding effect of the centrifugal force is acting outward, P is acting outward, and it will be counteracted by frictional force developed between the tire of the vehicle and the pavement surface. So when the vehicle is on the road, on the pavement, there is a reaction, vertical reaction acting upward, which will counteract the weight of the vehicle. We can say Ra plus Rb is equal to W. And frictional force is a function of this Ra and Rb, where a frictional force acting between say this is a tire A and this is a tire B, then frictional force acting between tire A and the pavement surface is Fa, which is equal to coefficient of friction into Ra, and the frictional force acting at B is Fb into coefficient of friction into Rb, and both will be acting in the opposite direction of the centrifugal force. So we can write P is equal to F into P is equal to Fa plus Fb, where Fa is F into Ra, Fb is F into Rb. So we can write P is equal to F into Ra plus Rb, or Ra plus Rb is W. So I am substituting this with W. So P is equal to F into W. Now what is centrifugal ratio? P by W. So P by W is F. So we can write P, when P by W is equal to coefficient of friction of that particular surface, then there is a danger of transverse skidding. If a slight increase in P by W value will result in the transverse skidding of this vehicle towards outer direction. So this, therefore, we must keep the value of centrifugal ratio less than B by 2H in order to prevent overturning, and we have to keep the P by W less than coefficient of friction in order to prevent transverse skidding of the vehicle. So these are the two important conditions for safety of the vehicle who is moving through circular curve without any super elevation. So what if B by 2H, which is which will turn into overturn the vehicle, B by 2H is less than coefficient of friction, then overturning will occur first, or we can say before skidding the vehicle will overturn. If the F is less than B by 2H, vehicle will skid before it overturns. So, whether the vehicle will overturn or skid will depends upon these two factors. It depends upon the value of B by 2H and coefficient of friction. If B by 2H is less than coefficient of friction, then the vehicle will overturn. If F is less than B by 2H, vehicle will skid. Both these cases will occur only when P by W is less than both the values. Okay. And if the pavement is horizontal, the pressure on the outer wheel will be higher. If this is the outer side and this was the inner side, then obviously the centrifugal force is trying to overturn this vehicle or trying to move this vehicle outward, then the pressure on this outer wheel is higher than that of inner wheel. Okay. While limiting equilibrium condition for overturning, the pressure at the inner wheel becomes zero. When it is about to overturn, the pressure at this wheel will become zero. So, in order to counteract the effect of centrifugal force, or in order to prevent the vehicle overturn or skid, we provide super elevation. So, super elevation is provided to counteract the effect of centrifugal force or to reduce the tendency of the vehicle to overturn or skid in a horizontal curve. So, super elevation. What is super elevation? It is the rising of the outer edge of the pavement with respect to inner edge in order to prevent the overturning or skidding due to the centrifugal force on a vehicle. So, super elevation is a transverse slope provided to counteract the effect of centrifugal force to reduce the tendency of the vehicle to overturn and skid by rising the pavement outer edge with respect to the inner edge. So, we have to keep the pavement like this. We have to rise the outer edge of the pavement with respect to inner edge. Okay. And this super elevation is noted by, represented by E, and it's also called Cantor banking. So, say this is M, N and O. So, super elevation E is equal to tan theta, which is equal to M N by O N, and maximum value of this tan theta is about 0.07, which is very small. So we can write tan theta is also equal to sine theta, almost equal to sine theta, and in sine theta we can write it's M N by O M, where M N is the rising of the outer edge. Let me call it as E, and OM is the width of the road surface. Let it be V. So I can write sine theta, or which is E, is equal to E by B, or I can write E is equal to small e into capital B. So, how much extent we have to increase the height of the outer edge with respect to inner edge can be found out from this equation. Super elevation into width of the road will give you the rise of the outer edge with respect to inner edge. Okay. So, this is super elevation, and let us analyze the super elevation. So, there are a few forces acting on the vehicle when the vehicle is moving through a circular curve. The forces are, first one is centrifugal force. Centrifugal force, we have seen what is centrifugal force, and we know the equation that the centrifugal force is equal to W V square by GR, and weight of the vehicle is W, and frictional force acting between tire and the pavement surface. So these are the three forces that are acting or that are developed due on the circular on a vehicle while it's moving through a circular curve. So I have a figure of it. I have placed a vehicle on a super elevated road surface, Now let us see what are all the forces acting on this particular vehicle. So we have weight and centrifugal force acting outward, and theta is the super elevation. Tan theta is the super elevation, or theta is the inclination of this particular rod. If this is theta, this one will also become theta. So if this is W, this one is W cos theta, and if this is P, this one will be P cos theta and P sin theta. If this is W, this one is W cos theta and this one is W sin theta. Since this is right angle. Okay, and another forces acting are coefficient frictional force Fa and Fb, which is acting the opposite direction of centrifugal force, and Ra and Rb acting upward, which counteract the weight component of weight and centrifugal force, which are acting downwards. So from this point, when a vehicle is in equilibrium, we can write P cos theta is equal to W sin theta plus Fa plus Fb. So P cos theta is acting outward in horizontal direction. W sin theta, Fa and Fb are acting in the opposite direction in the same plane. So P cos theta is equal to W sin theta plus Fa plus Fb. And we know Fa is equal to F into Ra and Fb is F into Rb. So we can write P cos theta is equal to W sin theta plus F into Ra plus Rb. And what is Ra plus Rb? Ra plus Rb is, they are acting upward. So let us see what are all the forces acting downward. They are W cos theta and P sin theta, right? So Ra plus Rb is equal to P sin theta plus W cos theta. So P cos theta is equal to W sin theta plus F into P sin theta plus W cos theta. So we have this equation. P cos theta is equal to W sin theta plus F into P sin theta plus W cos theta. Now I am keeping all the P terms left hand side and W terms in right hand side. So P cos theta, when F P sin theta went to this side, it will become minus F P sin theta, and W sin theta plus F into W cos theta. So in just taking out the P term and W term and making it as a common factor. So P into cos theta minus F sin theta is equal to W into sin theta plus F cos theta. Dividing this entire equation with cos theta. So dividing this equation with cos theta, we can write P into cos theta by cos theta is 1. Sin theta by cos theta is tan theta. Here also sin theta by cos theta tan theta, cos theta by cos theta 1. So P into 1 minus F tan theta is equal to W into tan theta plus F. So P by W is equal to tan theta plus F divided by 1 minus F into tan theta. So P by W is equal to tan theta plus F. If I told you, the value of tan theta is maximum 0.07, and coefficient of friction is taken as 0.15. So F into tan theta will become 0.15 into 0.07, which is almost equal to 0.010 something. So 0.01, which is the F tan theta. If I take 1 minus F tan theta, which is equal to 1 minus 0.01, which is 0.99, almost equal to 1 itself. So I am taking this entire term as 1. So our equation become P by W is equal to tan theta plus F. And we know what is tan theta? It is super elevation, or rate of super elevation. So P by W is E plus F, where E is the tan theta or super elevation. And we have already found out what is P by W. It is B squared by GR. So I am substituting this equation with v square by gr. Thus p by w with v square by gr. So our equation become e plus f is equal to v square by gr, where v is the speed of the vehicle, g acceleration due to gravity, r radius, e is the rate of super elevation, f is lateral frictional coefficient, which is taken as 0.15. So this equation is when we take the velocity or speed of the vehicle in meter per second. If the velocity is given in kilometer per hour, our equation become e plus f is equal to v square by 127 r. If the coefficient of friction is neglected, e is equal to v square by gr or v square by 127 r. That is, we are neglecting the coefficient of frictional term, f is equal to 0. When f is equal to 0, the equation become e is equal to v square by gr. And if e is equal to 0, then f is equal to v square by gr. Or we can say, if there is no friction in that particular road, then we must provide the super elevation such a way that it have to counteract entire centrifugal force. So the super elevation should be equal to v square by gr or v square by 127 r. And in some cases like roundabouts, we may not be able to provide super elevation. So in that case, we have to provide this frictional coefficient so high so that it have to counteract the entire centrifugal force. So f is equal to v square by gr, or we can say we can allow the speed of the vehicle to the maximum. V is equal to root of 127 into f into r. So we will provide a speed restriction in that particular area, since the maximum value of f is 0.15, and then we have to restrict the speed in order to prevent overturning or skidding of the vehicle. That's all about horizontal curve and super elevation. Thank you.